So in the NumPy, basically it was about the array. Now the pandas is the next step of that. In pandas, we have to work with the data frame. We have to work with the data frame and the series. This is just the next step of the NumPy. Now you can ask me like what exactly the data frame is. In the layman term, I am just going to tell you like what exactly the data frame is. Data frame is nothing. It is just like the Excel sheet. In the Excel sheet, we are having the row. We are having the columns. We are having the row and column. The same thing is there with the data frame. I will describe what exactly the series is, what exactly the data frame is. But what I am saying, like Panda is the next step of the NumPy. NumPy was basically on just how to handle the array. The good thing about the NumPy is it's their memory management. It's their memory management and their speed. That's the important thing. Now, what we are going to start with, we are going to start with the pandas. And pandas is going to talk about the data frame and the series. Now, you can ask me like if the data frame is just like the Excel sheet, then what is the use of this pandas? Why I'm going to use the pandas? I can use the simple Excel over there. In Excel, we are having a lot of functions and everything we can do with the Excel. So what is the use of this special pandas? Now, the thing is that, listen, like pandas library is written in Python. It's developed in Python. It's basically written in Python entirely. All the functions and all, everything is written with the Python. So the thing is that if I'm going to handle with the data frame in the pandas, so naturally we are having the ability to put the Python functions over there. We can also take the advantage of the NumPy. That's the good thing. Like, so it's not only the pandas. By the use of pandas, what we can do, we can read the data frame, we can read the Excel sheet, we can read the data from the Excel. And what we can do using the NumPy, we can put the multiple manipulations over there. So basically it's a combination. Like panda is basically it's a data frame. It's again on that particular data we can apply the NumPy. NumPy is basically it's good for the memory management and for the speed purpose. And a lot of other functions are there in the Python that we can apply with the pandas that we cannot apply with the Excel sheet. So only Excel sheet is not self-sufficient. That's why this pandas is required. So first of all, I will discuss about the pandas and all. First of all, I'm just going to start with the pandas, like what exactly the panda can do for us, or how we can start with the panda. So the first thing that we need to do, we are having the Jupyter is there. It's a notebook. Normally we need to write the data analytics like code in the Jupyter. Basically it displays the data in the clear format. That's the good thing. Like if I'm going to create the single dimensional array, if I'm going to create the multi-dimensional array, it will display the data in proper format. Same with the data frame and all. So we are having the Python is installed with my system. So the first thing is required the Python, exactly. The second thing, NumPy is already installed with me, installed with our system. And the third thing is Jupyter notebook is already installed with our system. So one extra installation is required over there. What we need to do, we need to install the pandas. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to start with the pandas installation. So how we can do this? I'm just going to open the command prompt. And I'm just going to write like pip install pandas. So now it's going to install your pandas over there. Yeah, we'll take time, we'll get installed. But if we are going to start with the pandas, NumPy must be installed over there, Python must be installed over there, Jupyter must be installed over there, and after that we can start with the pandas. Otherwise, if you are going to write the pandas code in the IDLE, that's not make sense. So that's the important thing. Now Panda is ready to get installed with us. Now I'm just going to close this. Now installation portion, let's get ready for me. So I'm just going to describe the few things over there about the data frame, about the series, and about the pandas. So first of all, if I need to discuss with pandas, what exactly the pandas is. So Panda is basically, it's open source. We don't need to purchase a license. Open source data analysis library. Written in Python. Remember, NumPy is written in C language. NumPy is written in C language. Remember, pandas get written in Python. So Python is this, pandas is basically what? It's an open source data analysis library written in Python. Now, the good thing about the panda is having the power of NumPy and Python. You can apply the NumPy, you can apply the Python over there. Rich set of library. Rich set of library we are having over here. Now, in the pandas, mainly we are having the two types of data structure is there. In pandas, mainly we are having the two types of data structure is there. One is known as series. Series is nothing, it's one dimensional array. It's one dimensional array. Series is nothing, it's a one dimensional array. One dimensional array with index will be there naturally. If I'm going to consider the Excel, in Excel the indexes will be there, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 with indexes, and that can be in the single row or single column. It can be there in the single row or it can be there in the single column. It can be there in the single row or it can be there in the single column. So series is nothing, it's just a one dimensional array with index like single row or the single column. And when we are talking about the, so series is basically what? Suppose I am going to open the Excel. If I am going to open the Excel, suppose we are having the data called, like we are having the employee number, we are having the employee name, we are having the salary. So employee number is like this, and we are having the employee name. We are having the employee name, we are having the salary, we are having the salary. So this is what? This is the series. This is what? This is the series. This is what? This is the series. And the entire is the data frame. So what exactly the data frame is? Series is basically it's one dimensional array with index here. Yeah? We are having the index over there. I'm just going to insert, yeah. The indexes will be there, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the indexes. It can be anything, it's an employee number, it can be anything. So this is basically what? It's an index. Now what exactly the data frame is? This entire is the data frame. So series is basically it's a single dimensional array with index, with single row and single column. And what is data frame? If I'm talking about the data frame is just a tabular spreadsheet, we can say. Tabular spreadsheet, or we can say it's a multi-dimensional array, like multi-dimensional array. Like multi-dimensional array with multiple column, with multiple rows and multiple columns. multiple columns. Remember one important thing, the data type will be same. It's a collection of same data type. Yeah, if I'm going to put the salary, this is the series. Yes, it's numeric only. Now, so data type will be same over here, but in data frame, it's a multiple data type will be there. Yeah, it belongs to a string, it belongs to number, it belongs to number. So it's a multiple data type will be there. Data type, it's a different data type will be there. Or what we can say, like combination of the series is known as basically the data frame. That's it. Combination of series is known as data frame. So what I'm trying to say, like one dimensional array is the series, and the two dimensional data, it's basically it's a data frame, or the entire spreadsheet, we can consider it as a data frame. So that's the important thing. Like in the previous concept, it was axis 0 and axis 1. That we need to understand. Here we just need to understand the data frame and series of the data. Okay, let me start with some demo so you can understand all these things. I'm just going to close this. What I'm going to start, I'm just going to start with the E drive. I'm going to create a folder. It's a G1 folder is there. Okay, I'm going to leave this. I'm going to create a new folder over here. New folder. And I'm going to create a folder called pandas. You can give any name over there. Pandas. Yeah. Here I'm going to use right click. And I'm just going to open my open command window here. We are in pandas right now. I'm just going to start with the Jupyter. How to start with the Jupyter notebook? What we need to write? Jupyter
notebook. Wrong spelling. Pandas is the folder that you create, right?
Yeah, pandas is my folder.
Okay.
Why Jupyter is not going to recognize this? I need to check the path. What was the spelling earlier? Oh. So right now we are in the pandas folder, and now I'm going to start with this. I'm just going to start with like new. What we need to start with at Python 3. Now, I'm going to write my program. So the first thing that we need to do, I need to import the pandas and I need to import the numpy. So this is the first thing we need to do. I'm just going to write import numpy as np. Nothing wrong with this. And I'm also going to import pandas as, I'm just going to use the pd. ship tanker. Yeah, it's ready now. Now what I'm going to do, before the complex data frames and all, I'm just going to create a dictionaries. In the dictionaries, I'm just going to put some values over there. So I'm just going to write dict1 is equal to, and in the dictionary I'm going to put the values. I'm just going to put the values over there. So I'm just going to put the values for name, the name, and this is the key, and what value I want to put in the name. So suppose in the name I'm going to put like Santosh. Again, I'm going to put like Smith. Again, I'm going to put like Rahul. Yeah, so three values there. That's more than sufficient for me. Now I'm going to put the another values over there. So these are the name. Other than name, I want to store the marks of that particular student. And I'm going to put the marks for, I'm just going to put like, for Santosh, I'm going to put the marks like 99. For Smith, I'm going to put the marks like 88. And for Rahul, I'm just going to put marks like 55. Again, other than this, I need to put the comma. Again, other than this, marks, I'm just going to give like city. Suppose I'm going to put the city over there. In the city, I'm just going to put like Santosh belongs to Delhi. And suppose Smith is from London, and Rahul is from Sydney. Yeah. So I have created the dictionary. In this dictionary, these are the value, name and all. So now it's done. Yeah. So dictionary get created. So what I need to do now? I need to create the data frame from this dictionary. Data frame is nothing, it's just like your Excel spreadsheet. So I want to create the Excel spreadsheet like from the dictionary. So how we can do that? For that, I'm just going to write df is equal to, data frame is equal to, I'm just going to use pd dot. Pd is what? It's a alias name of the pandas. So I'm just going to use pd dot data frame. Pd dot data frame. So I'm just going to use pd dot data frame. And what I'm going to pass, I'm just going to pass the dictionary over here, dict1, enter. Something is missing over there. Module pandas has no attribute name. I'm just going to write df is equal to pd dot. And I'm just going to use data frame. And what frame I'm going to use? I'm just going to use dictionary over there. Dict1. Shift enter. Yeah, that was a mistake. It's basically follow the Pascal convention. Like every first character will be capital. Now, if I'm going to display the df, enter. Yeah, see, this is your Excel spreadsheet now. We are getting the data like this. We are getting name, we are getting marks, we are getting city, and this is our gerund 1 and 2. This is the beauty of this data frame. By simple, I have just created the dictionary over there. In this dictionary, we are having the name, marks, and city, and these are the values over there. I am going to create the data from this particular dictionary. Now, if I'm going to write the df, and we are getting like this, these things are there like 0, 1, and 2, and we are getting the data. That's good. So, by the use of single line command, we are getting the data like Excel sheet. So, we are having the row and we are having the column, the individual columns are there. Okay, now what I want to do, I want to create the CSV file, comma separated file, values. CSV stands for comma separated values. So what I want to do, I want to create the CSV file from this. So how we can create the CSV file? I'm just going to write df dot to underscore CSV. So I'm just going to create the CSV file from this data frame. And I'm going to give the name of the CSV file. Suppose I'm going to give the name like list1.csv. So it will create a CSV file for you. Yeah, file get created. Just go in this particular location in pandas c. We are having the list1.csv file is there. Open this CSV file. Open with Excel. Yeah, that's great. Now we are having the name, we are having the marks, we are having the city. But one problem is there, we are also having the indexes. I don't want to display the index like this. So I don't want this index over here. So what we can do now? I don't want the index. So if we are not looking for the indexes, by default it will give you the index. But if I don't want to get the index and all, what we can do, we can simply write, everything will be the same. I'm just going to write, I'm going to create the another CSV over there, and here I'm just going to put one value parameters over there. I'm just going to write index is equal to false. Index is equal to false. Run this. Yeah, check it out. We are having the list2.xls. We don't have that particular index. So this is the beauty of this pandas. Even after writing the two line of code, you are getting the data in the Excel format. In the proper format, we are having the data and all. That's the beauty of this data frame of the pandas. That's why panda is basically good for the analytics purpose. Now, what I need to do right now, how many data we are having? It's only 3 records is there. So it's fine for you, like you are getting the data. And suppose if we are having like multiple records is there, in that case, what will happen? Because there is some limitation, like how it will display the data. So what we can do, we can simply use df dot data frame dot, we can apply head. If I'm going to put head, we are going to get the first record, initial first record. If I'm going to put df dot, if I'm going to use tell, df dot tell, I'm just going to write 2. So it's going to display the last 2 record. So we can use, but see, index is not going to change. So it's maintain the index integrity. Like 0 and 1, this record was there, and 1 and 2, now this record was. So we are having the head, we are having the tail, so we can do these things. And one important thing is there, like we are going to use df dot data frame dot, we can use describe. See the beauty of this pandas. I'm just going to write df dot describe, enter. See, this is the beauty of this pandas. You don't need to write the long SQL queries. I am getting the count of the marks. I am getting the mean of the marks. I am getting the standard deviation of the marks. I am getting the minimum marks. I am getting the 25% of that. I am getting the 50% of that. I am getting the 75% of that. And I am getting the maximum values over there. That's the beauty of this pandas. Suppose, like if these data is available with my Oracle database, for this purpose, what you need to do? You need to write long code over there. You need to put select, max, mean, lot of functions, then you need to apply. But here, I'm just going to put df.describe and we are getting the data like this. Okay, do one thing. I'm going to create the dictionary with some more values over there. So I'm just going to execute the dictionary again. I'm going to create the dictionaries. I'm going to put some extra value over there. And that will be good for the better understanding. Yeah. I'm going to put some extra values over there. The same thing I need to do over here. The same thing I'm going to put over here. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to give another field also over there, like I'm going to use, I'm going to put extra field over there, like suppose I'm going to consider it as marks 1 and I'm going to consider it as marks 2. Run this. Yeah. Now, once again, I'm going to create the data from this dictionary. DF. These are the data we are having. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write df dot describe. df.describe. See, without any instruction, without anything, it's going to display the description of the marks 1 and marks 2 both the column. So I'm just going to write marks 1. We are getting the detail of the marks 1 and we are going to get the detail of the marks 2. So everything here we are getting. So this is what exactly the good thing about this describe. So it's a small function that can do magic for me. Now what I want to do, suppose we are having the Excel file. Right now in the earlier example, we just created the CSV file. Now what I want to do, I want to read the data from the CSV file. How we can do that? So suppose this is the Excel file we are having. I'm just going to create the open the Excel file once again. Open. I'm going to open this file and going to put some extra values over there. Now, these are the values, file, save, yes. So, what is the name of the file? It's list2.csv, yeah, list2.csv. So, what I want to do, I want to read this particular file. So, how we can read this? I'm just going to write x is equal to, I'm just going to write like pd dot, what I need to do, I need to write read underscore CSV and I'm going to give the name of the file. My file name was list2.csv. Enter. I'm just going to write x. See how simple is this? Without writing anything, I'm just writing one line of command over there. We are able to read the Excel file. If we are able to read the Excel file, by writing one line of command over there, we are able to export the data to the Excel. So this is how this pandas work for. So basically it works on the data frame, it works on the series. That's the beauty of the panda. Suppose what I want to do, I want to use like we are having name is there and marks is there and city is there. So what I want to do, I'm just going to write x of, and suppose I'm going to write colon, and we are having the name, it's in uppercase. I'm just going to use name and enter. We just need to use the single quotation over there. Yeah, we are only getting the name. And what is the object type over here? It's object. Now suppose I'm going to use, I don't want to display all the data, I want to display only the few records over there. So what we can do, I'm simply writing x of, and what I need to get the name and I also need to give like, I'm going to give like 0. So you will get the name. Yeah, we are getting from the 0 cell, from the Santosh that we are getting. So this is how we can do this. So what I'm trying to say, like, we can read the data from the CSV file, we can put the data into the CSV file. So this is how we can do that. Okay, suppose I'm going to write like X, I'm going to display. Now we are having these types of indexes are there, like we are having 0, 1 and 2 and all. So we are having these things are there. And okay, my earlier data frame was DF. Yeah, DF was there. I'm just going to work with the DF. I'm just going to use the DF over there. So we are having the name, we are having the marks, we are having the city. And okay, what I want to do, suppose I'm going to write like I want to create the change the index. Right now what the index we are having, it's 0 1 2 3 4. Ideally it should be the numeric index. Index should be numeric. But what I want to do, I want to make the changes with that. So how we can do that? I'm just going to write df dot index is equal to how many records we are having. It's 8 record is there. I'm just going to put the values for it. And I'm just going to give like a comma. I can give first, second, third like that. BB comma CC comma DD comma E. So 6 and 7. Right. Yeah. Right records were there. Enter this. DF dot index is equal to something is missing over there. I need to check. How many records were there? It's 9 records is there. That's where the problem is. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. I'm just going to put the another value over there. Yeah, it was the 9 record over there, but right now we are just getting 8. That's where the problem was. DF, see, now you change the index also. So even you can also change the index, but ideally we should avoid this. Like index always, it should be like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the ideal scenario. But even we can also change the row index over there. So this is how we can work with the pandas. So if I want to work with the pandas, what I need to do? The first thing we need to do, we just need to write like import numpy as np and import pandas as pd. This is the first thing. Now, the first concept was how to create the data frame, what exactly the data frame is. So we are having the dictionary, few values are there. And what I'm going to do, this is the command pd dot, pd is the pandas alias name, pd dot data frame of dictionary. It's going to create the spelling of the data frame that I need to remember. I'm just going to, so pd dot data frame, this is how we can get this. Now we are getting the data like this. And now we can, what we can do, we can convert this data into the CSV file, we can copy this in the CSV file, but it will also copy the index. I don't want to copy the index like 0, 1 and 2. So we can put the index is equal to false. If I'm going to put like head 2, it will only display the 2 record, initial 2. If I'm going to give like df.tail of 2, it will only display the last 2 records. If I'm going to put the describe, it's a good function. It will give you the max, mean, average, lot of things are there. Now again we are having the data frame, like this is how we can read the CSV file. This is how we can read the CSV file, pd.read_CSV. So what I'm trying to say, like if I need to make the CSV file, if I need to create the CSV file, we can use 2 CSV. If I need to read the data from CSV file, we can use read_CSV. So this is how we can read these values and all. even we can read the value from the individual field. Yeah, we can read the value from the individual field. So more or less, this is what exactly your panda is. These are the basic operations. That's what exactly the panda is for. Now, right now, we have just created the data frame for like simple data structure. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create something extra. Like now I'm going to implement the concept of series and the data frame. Right now it was just my purpose was just to describe the things like how the pandas work basically. What is the use of these pandas? Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create the data frame now. I want to create the data frame by the use of series. So what we can create the data frame by the use of series. So this is the standard way to create the data frame. So what I'm going to do, suppose I'm just going to write like z is equal to, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use pandas pd dot, and I'm going to create like series, pd dot series. So I want to create a series. Now I'm going to write np dot numpy, np dot random, random is the function over there, dot read. So it will read, and I'm going to put, suppose I'm going to put the values like 109. So what will happen if I'm going to run this? So I'm just going to create the data frame. I'm going to create the series. It's not the data frame, it was the data frame. Now I'm going to create the series, pd dot series. I'm going to create the series of like single dimensional array. I'm going to create, and how many values it's going to put, I'm just going to create like np dot random dot read, and I'm going to give the values like I want to create the series of 20 values. I'm just going to create the series of the 20 values. Now if I'm going to run this, np dot random dot read has, you just need to check it out like, okay. Oh, sorry. Rand, it's not great. Yeah, it's get created. Now I'm going to write Z. See, we are getting the series of the values, and this value is a random value we are having. And how many series it's going to create? It's 20 series is going to create. So this is we are creating by the use of pandas. Like I'm going to write, sorry, numpy. I'm just writing pd dot series. So how many series we are looking for? So I'm just going to put np dot rand of 20. Suppose, see what is the data type over here? By default, d type is float 64. I can also check it out. Like I'm going to write type of z. See, pandas code dot series, it belongs to series type. Earlier it was like the data frame, now it's a series. So this is how we can create the series. So to create the series, this is how we can use. The method is pd.series. Now, what I want to do, I want to create the data frame. So I'm just going to write new df. I'm just going to write new df is equal to, we are having the pd pandas dot data frame, pd dot data frame. And what I want to create, I need to define how many rows will be there and how many column will be there. So I'm just going to write np dot and I'm just going to use a random dot rand. I'm just going to put the rand value over there, and then I'm going to put the row and column. Like suppose we are looking for 20 row and we are looking for 5 columns over there. So it's going to create the row 20 row and 5 columns over there, and just do this, enter. Now, if I'm going to write new df, new df, yeah, we are having the 20 rows and we are having the 5 columns, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we are having the 5 column and we are having the 20 rows over there. See, basically if we are having the use data, it will display the data like this. So what we can do, we can use the head function over there. Like we can use new df dot head. That will be better. So if I'm going to use simply head, it will display initial few records over there. It's only going to display the 4 record over there. Or if I'm going to put like head 5, it will display the 5 record, or 10, it will display the 10 record. That's it. Now we can also, I want to check it out, like what are the data types over there. So I'm just going to write type of like new df. It's a panda.core.frame. It's a data frame. So this is how we can check like what data type is this. Suppose I'm going to use like new df dot describe. If I'm going to run this, see, we are getting each and everything of every column 0, column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4. These are the value that we are getting over here. Now if I want to check the data type, I'm just going to write new df dot d type. See, in 0 row the data type is float, in 1 is float, 2 is float. So this is the data type of each and every row that we are getting. Even suppose right now if I'm going to run new df, if I'm going to run the new df over there, we are having the D data we are having. Now what I want to do, if I'm going to make the changes over there, if I'm going to put some changes, how we can do that? This is just like array, we can do that, like new df of 0 0. In 0 0, suppose I'm going to put like Santosh, I just make the changes with this. Yeah, now if I'm going to write new df, yeah, it's get Santosh. Now if I'm going to write new df dot, and I'm going to use the d type, so what will be the d type over there? See, for the 0 row the d type is object. Why it's object? Because one value is there and that value is going to contain Santosh. It's a string value, so it's a combination of a string and float. That's why we are getting the data type object over there, otherwise by default it was float. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write like new df dot, I'm just going to put like index, enter. Yeah, I'm just getting the index. It gets started from 0, stop at 2, and step is basically it's 1. So we are getting the detail of that. Suppose I'm going to write new df dot, I'm just going to use columns, enter. Column is range from 0, stop at 5, and step is 1. So we are getting the detail about the, like, so this is basically your data frame, and this is how we can work with the data frame, and this is how we can work with the series. So earlier this value was the series, and this is the data frame. Now the question is, this is my data frame, new df. What I want to do, I want to convert this data frame to NumPy array. I want to convert this data frame to NumPy array. How we can do that? If I need to convert into the NumPy array, what we need to do, we just need to write new df dot 2_NumPy. This is the function that we need to apply. Yeah, see, now this is the array structure we are having. So this is how you can convert it into the NumPy, and then you can put any types of manipulations over there. That's basically the sequence. Like we are having the data in the Excel and all, we can read the data in the pandas. From the pandas, we can create the data frame, we can put the manipulation. For the further manipulation, what we can do, we can convert this into the NumPy object, and then we can put the manipulations with the NumPy. Suppose I'm going to use new df dot t, t is also there. Yeah, it will transpose. See, it transposes your data. 0, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, the row get converted into the column and column get converted into the row. Suppose I'm just going to write new df dot, I'm just going to write new df dot head. So we are going to get the head over there. Yeah, we are getting the few values over there. Okay, what I want to do, I want to sort on the basis of index. I want to apply the sorting on the basis of the index. So how we can do that? We can apply new df dot, we can apply sort underscore index. By default, it's already sorted. We are having 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's already sorted. What I want to do, I want to apply the sorted on the basis of row. And to represent the row, what we need to use, you remember, we need to use axis. So I'm just going to use axis is equal to 0. So I'm going to arrange the data on the basis of row. On the basis of row, axis 0 means row, axis 1 means column. Now I'm going to put like ascending is equal to, I'm going to give false. Run this. Yeah, we are getting the data like this. It's going to arrange the data on the basis of axis of 0, and it's going to display the data in descending order. I'm just putting the ascending is equal to false. Suppose I want to arrange the data on the axis y, so like the column, how we can do that? In the place of like, can you imagine if I need to work all these things with the ideally, what will happen? I'm just going to put like axis 1, run this. Yeah, the data get arranged according to this particular axis, 4, 3, 2, 1. So this is how we can apply the sorting over there. We can apply the sorting over there. Now what I want to do, suppose I want to create, I'm just going to write, okay, so we are having the data frame. Now my data frame is new df. I'm just going to make the copy of that. One interesting concept is there, and that particular concept is basically, we can say it's a concept of views. It's a concept of views. Even here we are having the concept of views. So what exactly the view is? Suppose I'm just going to write new df2 is equal to new df, enter. What do you think? If I'm going to print new df2, it's a copy of new df? Yeah, exactly. If I'm going to work with a new df, it's the same thing that we are getting. Okay, so we are having the two different thing over there. It's a new df2 and we are having the new df. Okay, what I'm going to do, I'm going to change the new df2. Remember, I'm not going to change the new df. I'm just going to change the new df2. I'm going to put some another value over there. So how we are going to do this, I'm just going to write new df2 of 0 and 0. Here I'm just going to put like g. Yeah, it's a warning message, it's not the error. I will tell you like what exactly it is. Now if I'm going to run the new df2, Yeah, it's get change, now it's G. In the place of Santosh, it's now G. And what about the new DF1, the actual table? I'm just going to write new DF, the actual table. It's get change over here also. Remember, when we apply like new DF2 is equal to new DF, that's not exactly a copy of this. This is just the view.
Reference.
Yeah, this is just the reference. So if I'm going to make any changes with the new DF2, indirectly we are going to make the changes with the new DF. So this is the concept of the views in the pandas. So that we need to remember. Now, my question is, I don't want to apply the view. What I want to do? I want to copy. I don't want to apply the view. So how we can do that? So I'm just going to write new df3 is equal to, I'm just going to write new df dot. I need to use the keyword copy over there. Now this is the copy. Now if I'm going to make the changes with the new df3, it's not going to make any impact on new df. If I'm going to make the changes with new df3, if I'm going to write new df3 of 0 and 0, here I'm going to put like Hermine if I'm going to write new df3 oh new df3 yeah it's get change Hermine, but if I'm going to write new df, it's already G is there. So this is how we can make the copy. If I'm just going to put like new df2 is equal to new df1, it will just create the views over there. So this is the important concept that we need to remember.
Can you go back up? I didn't see.
Pardon?
Can you just scroll up a little bit for me? A little more? Okay. So you got to write the copy.
Yeah, copy method is there that we can do.
Is that the same as decopy, or decopy is different?
Pardon?
Oh, it's okay. All right. That's good.
I got it. Your question is a different question. Here it's just the copy. It's another copy. It's a separate file. Okay. Now, remember, like if I'm going to make the changes like new df of 0 and 0, if I'm going to write new df of 0, 0 is equal to, and I'm going to give like tata, everything is perfectly fine, but it's going to give me some message over there. This is what exactly, why this message is coming. If I'm going to write new df, yeah, why this message is coming? Remember, this is not the way to change the data. This is not the appropriate way to make the changes the data. This might create the problem. Right now we don't have the chain. Like chain means what? Like new df2 is there. New df2 is copy of new df. Might be the new df3 will be there. That will be the copy of new df2. So if suppose we are having the chain of data, so it will get confused. And remember, NumPy basically manages things accordingly. So what I need to do, if I need to make any changes with, so this is not the way to make the changes. For the beginner it's fine, but if you need to make any changes, this is the method that we can apply. What we can apply? I'm just going to write new df dot, we are having the method called lock. I'm just going to apply new df of lock. And now I'm going to make the changes with this. So this is the proper way to apply the copy, to make the changes. Run this, yeah. If value is trying to set a copy of slash from the data frame, in trip word for launching iPhone kernel, run this. New DF, it should not come. New DF. If I'm going to run this new df.loc lock, I'm going to apply for, oh sorry, 0, 2 like this. Lock is a function, like we need to apply like this. Yeah. If I'm going to apply new df now, yeah, it's get changed. And after making the changes, we are not getting any error. So always we should apply the LOC to just get the values, to set the values. It's not directly you are going to use this. Now, what I'm going to do, suppose I'm going to write, I'm just going to write like, right now we are having 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to make the changes with this. I'm going to change the column for this. Like we can also change the row index, we can also change the column index. If I'm going to make the column change the with the column index, how we can do that? I'm just going to write new df dot columns. New df dot columns is equal to, suppose I'm going to apply the Python list over here, and I'm going to put like A B C D E. A B C D E. Yeah. If I'm going to run new df, yeah, now it's get change A B C D E. By default it's get, I mean like earlier it was 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is how we can make the changes with this, with the column and all. Now what I'm going to do, I want to make the changes with the special column. Like I want to, here we are applying 0, 0. 0 means this 0 and this 0 means this 0. If I want to make the changes with this column, I want to make the changes with 0 and A, then what we need to do? Here we don't have 0 and 0. If I'm going to make the changes with 0 and 0, if I'm going to run new df, see what happened. It's not make the changes with this, it added the extra column over there. The column is 0. Set the value for this and the remaining value gets set null over there. Null. So this is the problem, because we are having the indexing, like we are having 0 and A indexing is there. So what I need to do, if I need to make the changes over here, how we can do that? We need to use like this. A. Now if I'm going to run new df.head, yeah, now it gets changed. So we can apply the lock like this also. But what about this extra column? What about this extra column? Unnecessary, this particular column is there with me. So what I want to do, I want to remove that particular column also. I want to remove this particular column also. So how we can do that? I'm just going to write new df is equal to new df. So whatever the changes I'm going to apply, that will get affected with the new df. So I'm just going to write new df is equal to new df dot drop, and what column we need to drop, it's a 0 comma, and I'm looking for this. So what axis I need to give over here? Yes, please. Axis is equal to 0, 1. It's a column I need to drop. New df. Yeah, that particular column get dropped. So this is how we can apply the drop over there. So this is what exactly the LOC is. Now, what I want to do, like we are having the LOC, in the place of LOC, what we can apply, one important function is there that we can use, that is called ILOC. I means the index. Remember, if we are having the alphabets, what we need to do? We need to use new df dot LOC 0 comma A. But suppose I don't want to use the A and B, C, I want to put the index always. So I'm just going to write new df dot, I'm just going to use ILOC, index, and I'm going to put like 0, like I'm going to give 0 comma 0. And this value I'm going to put like, I'm going to make the changes with this. Run this. Invalid token. Oh. 0, 0. Yeah, see, the changes get impacted. So remember, if I need to make the changes with, see, it's get changed. If I need to apply the changes with index only, I will go for the ILOC. Otherwise, with LOC, what you can do, you can put the index. If index is there, you can put the index. If alphabets is there, you can put the alphabets over there. So this is how we can do that. Suppose I want to drop this, I'm just going to write like new df dot head. I'm just going to write like new df dot head. So this is the data we are having. Now, what I want to do, I want to drop the row. Like I want to drop the row, like this particular row I want to drop. How we can do that? I'm just going to write new df dot drop. What I need to drop? I want to drop the zero record, zero. Enter. See, that particular get dropped. That particular record, row get dropped. See? Zero get dropped. Now we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is how we can do that. Suppose I want to drop this A, all the A over there. So how we can do that? I'm just going to write new df dot. Suppose what I need to do, I need to use like new df dot drop. I want to drop like all the A, and I need to give the access over there. So I'm just going to write comma, access is equal to 1. Run this. Yeah, the A get removed, all the A get removed. But remember one thing, we are dropping the things, but my actual table is as it is. I'm not assigning these result with the any values. This is just like your select statement. You are just displaying the data. We are not assigning these with the anything and all. If I am going to run the new df, everything is as it is there. See, yeah, we are having the 0, we are having the A, B, C, everything is there, because you just drop that. You cannot you never apply that drop with that particular actual data frame. So what I want to do, I want to apply with the data frame also. So how we can do that? If I'm going to remove, I also want to apply with the data frame. So what we can do, I'm just going to write one parameter is there. We can apply the parameter. Like I'm just having the parameter. I'm just going to use like in place is equal to true. So I'm just going to write in place is equal to true. Now check it out. New df, yeah, that particular column get dropped. So this is the keyword that we can apply in place. But one important thing is there, like if I'm going to drop the row, suppose I'm writing like I'm just going to write I'm just going to write new df dot drop. What I need to drop, I'm just going to like I want to drop from 1 to A, 1 to 5, okay. And I'm going to put the access is equal to 0. Access is equal to 0. And I'm just going to put in place is equal to true. If I'm going to run new df, yeah, all the record from 1 to 5 get removed. See? Yeah, all the data get removed. But no. Oh, it's 1 to I'll run this. Some error is there. New df dot drop. I want to drop the from 1 to 5 and I'm going to put the access is equal to 0 and in place is equal to true. What the problem with this? Label not found in access. Okay, I'm just going to look like we are having B, C, D, E. Okay. Suppose I'm going to remove 3 and I'm just going to remove this and I'm going to put in place is equal to true. Yeah, get drop. I'm just going to write new df. This data is there. The 3 get removed. Now the index get changed. Now what I want to do, I want to change the index also. Like this is not the good, like 0, 2 and all these data is missing over there. So I want to reset the index. So how we can do that? I'm just going to write new df dot, we can apply reset dot index. New df dot, we are going to apply reset underscore index. Yeah, now the index got changed. It's a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So when you drop the things, it will get changed automatically. So what you can do, you can just apply the reset over there. So by the use of reset, it will get automatically set over there. Now, what I want to do, like I want to check if is there any null values. So how we can to check the null value? I'm just going to write new df dot new df of what, like in B. Like in B, I want to check is there null value. New df dot B of is null. We are having the is null function also over here. Yeah, we are getting the false because we don't have the is null over there. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to put the new df of B, and what I'm going to put, I'm just going to put like is equal to, and I'm going to give none. Now if I'm going to write new df dot is null, see, now it's true because in the new df we are having the null values. New df we are having the null values. Yeah, none is there. None is there. This is not a good practice to do the things like that. Ideally, if I'm going to do this, it should be like LOC function should be there, like new df of, it should be the LOC function over there, new df dot LOC. And what I want to do, I want to make the changes for the entire comma. And what column we are looking for, we are looking for B column. And then I'm just going to put like is equal to none. So this is the ideal way to do this. This is the ideal way to do this. Always, if you are going to make any changes, you should apply the lock. If I'm just going to put new df, yeah, we are getting the values like this. It's none value there. So this is how we can apply this lock and all. So basically, the entire pandas is basically data frame series. We need to work on these types of data over there. If I want to use like, if I'm going to put like df dot sep, sep is a function. If I'm, it's an attribute. If I'm going to use this, yeah, it's 9 and 4. So we are getting the shape over there. So suppose I'm going to apply like df dot info. Yeah, we are getting the info over there. 0, 1, 2, 3. We are having the name, marks, 1 and city. 9 null value is there. Count, data type, everything we are getting over this regarding this. So we can also apply df dot not null. Run this. Yeah, it's going to return the true and false whether it's a null or not. So we are having the not null. Now one important thing is there. Suppose in the Excel, I'm going to create the Excel file over there. Here I'm going to create the Excel file. Right click. I'm going to create the Excel file. In the Excel file, like we are having employee number, employee name and salary. 1, 2, 3, 4. These records are there. We are having ABCX. These records are there. We are having, and we are having the salary like 3000, 2000, 4000. I'm going to give the name of the seat like seat 1, and this is the seat 2 we are having. I'm just going to copy this with another seat, and I'm just going to copy over here. So now we are having the different seat. In this seat, I'm going to make the changes over here like 111, 112. Yeah, if I'm going to make this, so clearly you will get the picture like this data is coming from this seat. And now we are having the record over there like 8000. I'm going to put the 9000, and I'm going to put the values over there, and we are getting this value. So we are having the different set. I'm going to save this file, save, and I'm going to save this file within the pandas folder over there. Yeah, and suppose the name of the file is book1.xlx. yeah, it's fine. This file gets saved with me. So we are having the seat 1, we are having the seat 2. In the seat 2, the different data is there. In seat 1, we are having the different data over there. Now what I want to do, I want to create, read this Excel file. Okay, book 1. So how we can do that? I'm just going to write data is equal to pd dot Excel. Data is equal to pd dot Excel. Sorry, pd dot read underscore Excel. And what Excel file I need to read? I need to read book1.xlx. This is the file I need to read over there. And enter. We are getting the error. It's required some pip. Yeah. It's required the XLRD. So I'm just going to open the command prompt. And I'm going to install the XLRD. Pip install XLRD. It will get installed. Okay. Now if I'm going to read this. Shift enter. Now if I'm going to write data, we are getting the data from first Excel. Employee number, employee name and everything we are getting. But we are getting the data from the first Excel. I want to get the data from the second Excel sheet. How we can do that? We are getting the data from the first sheet. I want to get the data from the second sheet. So what I need to do, I just need to write over here, like sheet underscore name is equal to the name of the sheet and it's sheet 2. So run this. And now if I'm going to give the data, now the data is coming from I'm just writing data is equal to pd.readExcel. Excel sheet name is equal to sheet 2. It's in uppercase sheet 2. Run this. Data. Yeah, that was the mistake. It was sheet underscore name, it was in uppercase. So now we are getting the data from the sheet 2. So this is how we can do this. Now, what we can do, even we can apply the changes also over there. Suppose I'm going to apply the changes. I'm just going to write like data dot LOC of 0,0 is equal to, like right now it's 111. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to put like this. If I'm going to run the data, we are getting the data, it's get changed now. I need to put the name of the column over there. So I'm just going to put like 0 and I'm just going to give employee number. And I'm going to make the changes like this here. And if I'm going to run this, it's get changed now. So what I want to do, I want to put back in the Excel also. So how we can do this? I'm just going to write data dot 2 underscore Excel. And what Excel? I'm just going to give the name of the file, like book2.xlx. Or it's the same file we are looking for, book1.xlx, comma, I need to give the name of the seat. Seat is equal to, and it was seat 2. I want to make the changes over there. Seat 2. Run this. We are seat is equal to seat 2.
Seat name?
Oh.
Seat name, okay. Underscore name.
Seat underscore name. Now it's required some package over there. It's open py excel. This is I need to install. So I'm just going to use pip install open py excel. Yeah, it will get installed now. So this is all about the pandas. This is what exactly the pandas is. Now do this, run this. Yeah, check it out. Bookon.xlx. Yeah, it's get changed now. So what I'm trying to say, like this is how we can work with the pandas.